Hi guys, it's Blackie for Shaman's Forge Bushcraft. Okay, today I'm going to do something a little different. I'm going to talk about a gun, actually a handgun. When we go into the field, quite often it's very handy to have some sort of protection with us. Not like people talk about apocalypse, but it's handy whenever you're out in the field to have something to defend against snakes, rabid animals, etc. I live in the deep south, and down here there's a lot of things out there. A lot of things that will bother you. Like timber rattlers, diamondbacks, name it. Now I don't go looking for a problem, but it's very handy to have something small and personal I can have with me. Now of course, my favorite is my trade gun, my little single shot. But there's times that this is a little too bulky. I need both hands free or I'm in an enclosed thing. So I need something a little smaller. Now I've always used a 22. My favorite is a Ruger Single 6. But here lately, I've been thinking about something else. So I decided to get, like my father and my grandfather before me, a 38. Now, I know there's going to be some people say, 38, oh my God, what an end caliber. Why not get a 45 or a 40? It's because I'm not hunting people. And the 38 has been around for 100 years. It has tons of reloading information available, components and etc. And it's readily available with shot shells. And that's a real thing. Now, the one I picked up in a gun trade was brand new. And it's really a common man type gun. What this gun is a Rock Island Armory, or Arms Corps, I guess you'd call it, model 206. It's a snub-nose 38. It's very similar to the Colt 38, Colt Detective. I have a Colt Detective that was handed down to me by my father, so I'm very familiar with the style and design. It's kind of puggy, short, etc., but it's also very compact. It's also good heavy steel. I picked this up brand new for $200. That's a good deal in today's market. It carries a good warranty on it. It's got good solid steel in it, and I like the quality of it. Is it, you know, Colt quality? No. Is it state of the art? No. It's common man. This is a gun that I can carry in the field, as opposed to my father's old Colt Detective. Colt Cobra. If I lose this in an overturned canoe, I'm not going to cry so much. If this gun gets beat up, scuffed up in field use, which is what this is going to be due, if this ends up in the mud, I mean mud, it's sacrificable. And that's a bad way to say it, but you know what I mean. It's not an heirloom. It's a good, rock-solid gun that's going to perform what I needed to do. Now, it's a six-shot swing-out cylinder. It is now unloaded. The gun is double action or single action, has a wide trigger, which feels very comfortable. To remove the cylinder, you pull back and push out at the same time. Now, my personal, never slam the gun closed, that's dirty, hairy stuff. Push the gun closed till it clicks, rotate it till it's locked in battery. Slamming it puts a lot of wear and tear up here on the crane and makes for a cylinder that's wobbly. That's when you go to open it up and the cylinder wants to jam up because it wobbles. Accuracy goes down too. Just take your thumb, close it, and you'll hear it go click, and it's in battery. You're ready to go. Now, because this is such a small, handy size, it is perfect for a night gun. Something I can put close to me, up in the top of my hammock, like I said in my last video. And also, I can take this and conceal it in my bedroll. So, if the middle of the night I have a problem, like a rabid coyote, we have a lot of those, a rabid coon, a rabid skunk, all of those I've seen in the last year in my woods travels. Or, God forbid, I'm sitting here fishing and I'm concentrating on that line and everything else, and I look down and I've got a big moccasin right there. Now, I'm not going to go looking for trouble. I just don't want to be anything else's dinner or anything else's trouble either. That's what this is for. This can also serve well as a backup gun to that, or a standalone gun when I don't really want to carry my big gun. I need my hands free. I need my pack free. I'm clearing a trail and I need something right here, close and handy, as opposed to something kind of more bulky. That's what this serves for. Now, in a minute, I'll give you a real good close-up of it. And then I'm going to show you some footage of me shooting it to give you an idea. And then I'll show you the target, etc. I've been shooting it now for a little over a month, and I'm very impressed with it. It's got good accuracy, it's got excellent reliability, and it's a good hefty pistol. It's not no lightweight. All steel type construction. Feels good in the hand. Now, accuracy. What am I expecting out of this? I'm expecting this gun to perform with correct loads for it at 0 to 10 yards. This is a close range belly gun. I can shoot farther than that. I have practiced with it out to 25 yards, and I am real confident I can stay onto a rabbit size animal at 25 yards with it without problem. I can humanely take game if I need to. That's not what this job is. The other thing is, out to 10 or 15 feet, I want it to pulverize a baking potato on a stick. That's to represent a snake. If I've got one right here, I want pow, I want it over. If I have made the decision I have to take the life of this creature, I want it to be quick and humane. No wounding. I want the animal gone. I do not want it to suffer because I want it over. That's what this is going to do for me. Okay, stay with me and I'll show you shooting it. And then we'll look at, you know, up close and etc. Stay with me. I'll be right back. Okay guys, here's the revolver up close. Wood grips. They make several models of this, some with rubber-like Pacmar type grips, longer barrel, etc. They seem to be, in my area at least, going for somewhere around 200 to 250 depending on what accessories you get with it. But this is the size I chose to use in mine. Now, to open, just like that. Close it, just like that. Cock it. Now, a lot of people look at this hammer and think it's thin and flimsy. It's actually pretty robust for its size. That flat checkered actually does a good job at grabbing and cocking it. And it has I'm pretty sure you can't see that, a transfer bar safety, which means the gun is absolutely safe, hammer down on a live round. There's no firing pin. Only when the trigger is fully pulled can the firing pin engage. So the gun is safe to carry fully loaded. I like that, especially if it's going to be something on my body that I could fall with. So, that's a good close-up. Now let me move back to position. Okay guys, that's my take on the night gun, the backup gun, the belly gun, the up-close and personal gun, my little bitty trail companion. And this is what I'm going to be using for a while now. Will not be replacing my trade gun, but it will be my backup gun. It's also a gun that's going to ride in the vehicle with me when I'm going to and from, you know, traveling. Just common sense. Accuracy has proven to be very effective. If I'm within 10 yards, point and shoot. I could take squirrels with it at that range. And with snake shot in it, I'm confident I can defend myself against rattlers and etc. or moccasins or whatever I'm dealing with. I went to the Tennessee region above Mobile, Alabama. It's a huge swamp complex up in there. And me and a friend canoed over 100 miles in that area over a week. Multiple times in that as we went through thickly overgrown, overhung, very narrow little canoe areas, we've looked up and saw a big moccasin, eye level or slightly above it. This would have been real handy. You're not allowed to carry long guns in there unless it's hunting season and you got a license to hunt. You are allowed to carry personal defense weapons. So when we go back this March, this will be Riding with Blackie for Snakes. I hope this inspires you, and I hope it gives you an idea for a gun. As far as this Rock Island Armory 38, model 206, thumbs up from Blackie. He does a good job. I'm Blackie for Shaman's Forge Bushcraft, with wishing you safe journeys, and have a great day, guys.